Horror films are notorious for their clichés, yet some of these familiar tropes still manage to be effective. Whether it's because they tap into universal fears, build suspense, or play with audience expectations, certain horror clichés continue to work. Here's a look at some that remain potent. The final girl. Why it works? Well, the final girl trope, where one woman, often pure and resourceful, manages to survive a massacre. This has become a horror staple. Audiences root for her as she embodies survival, courage, and endurance. Films like Halloween with Laurie Strode and A Nightmare on Elm Street with Nancy Thompson perfected this cliché because of the emotional investment in her journey. It provides a cathartic experience for viewers and often aligns with feminist subtexts showing strength in adversity. Jump scares. Though overused, and when done right, jump scares can deliver a sudden jolt that momentarily releases built-up tension. It's all about timing and atmosphere. Classic films like The Exorcist and more modern ones like The Conjuring use jump scares sparingly to enhance their effectiveness. What makes it effective? Well, it preys on our natural instincts and responses to a surprise, heightening the fear factor in just the right moment. The creepy child. The creepy child is the juxtaposition of innocence with malevolence, and it really unnerves the audience. Films like The Omen and The Ring take advantage of our natural instinct to protect children and turn it on its head by making children the source of terror. Children represent purity, and their corruption or possession feels deeply unsettling and unnerving. The idea that something inherently good can turn evil plays on our psychological discomfort. The haunted house. The haunted house. There's something timeless about the fear of a house with a dark past. Films like The Amityville Horror and Poltergeist use this cliché to great effect because a home is supposed to be a place of safety. When it's invaded by the supernatural, that sense of security is shattered. So the haunted house taps into primal fears of our most familiar spaces, turning dangerous or uninhabitable. Don't go in there. Characters venturing into dark basements, attics, or dangerous areas where they shouldn't may seem illogical, but these moments build suspense and dread. Audiences know something bad will happen, and the tension created by waiting for the inevitable is palpable. How many times have we heard, "I'll be back soon, I won't be long"? It keeps viewers on the edge of their seats, often leading to a thrilling payoff when the unseen danger finally reveals itself. The monster you can't see. Fear of the unknown is a powerful psychological trigger. Movies like Jaws. For most of the film, we don't see the shark, and the Blair Witch Project capitalize on keeping the threat largely unseen, which allows the audience imagination to fill in the blanks. Our imaginations often conjure far worse images than what can be shown on screen, making the unseen monster a terrifying force. Isolation. Many horror films use isolation, whether physical, like in The Thing, or emotional, such as Hereditary, to enhance fear. When characters are cut off from help or escape, their vulnerability increases. Whether stranded in a remote location or socially alienated, isolation intensifies the tension. Isolation magnifies fear by removing the possibility of rescue, emphasizing the feeling of being completely alone against a threat. Mirror scares. The classic scene of a character looking into a bathroom mirror, then closing it to reveal something unexpected, still manages to send chills down viewers' spines. Movies like Candyman and Oculus use reflective surfaces to unsettle because mirrors have an eerie association with the supernatural. Mirror scares is a moment that plays with our expectations, often timed to create maximum tension before delivering a shock. The creepy old person. Old age is often linked with wisdom, frailty, and innocence. So when elderly characters are depicted as sinister or creepy, it adds an unnerving layer. Films like The Visit and Rosemary's Baby subvert this expectation, turning the elderly into figures of horror. And it really taps into the fear of the uncanny when something familiar, in this case the elderly, takes on an unnatural, frightening quality. Found footage. This style immerses the audience directly into the narrative, making the experience feel raw and unfiltered. The Blair Witch Project and Paranormal Activity are prime examples where DIY aesthetic and handheld camera movements amplify the tension. The realism aspect tricks the mind into feeling more personally connected to the horror as you're witnessing actual events unfold. The monster reveal at the end. Many films delay revealing the monster or evil entity until the very end, like in The Descent or Cloverfield. The build-up of suspense with hints and partial glimpses creates anticipation, making the final reveal more impactful. When it's done right, this structure builds tension throughout the movie and offers a satisfying and terrifying payoff. Possession. Demonic possession taps into ancient primal fears about losing control of oneself. Films like The Exorcist and The Conjuring use possession as a way to depict a body being controlled by a malevolent force, which is deeply disturbing to viewers. And it exploits the fear of losing control over one's mind and body, making it one of the most viscerally unsettling horror tropes. While these clichés are well-worn, their effectiveness lies in the filmmaker's ability to play with audience expectations, create suspense, and evoke primal fears. When used creatively, even the most predictable horror tropes can be chilling.